Siriganjiri Nemato
Hey everyone, I'm Bradley, and welcome to Zlangle. This is my spoiler discussion of Black Panther, the newest film in the MCU. And personally, it is probably my second favorite Marvel Studios movie ever. So I just really want to talk about some of my thoughts and the things I liked about it. I was excited for this movie because of the character, Wakanda, and I had faith in Ryan Coogler and Kevin Feige. And while it was high on my anticipation list, it was sort of the way I felt about The Winter Soldier before I saw it. I watched the trailer once or twice and thought it would be really good, but I didn't go into full-on nerd mode where I rewatched the trailers 100 times and spent tons of time thinking about it like I do for Infinity War or a Star Wars movie. But it was definitely on my radar, and oh man, if I had only known how much I would fall in love with this movie. To me, this is more than a solid Marvel film. This is near the pinnacle of their achievement so far. It's the perfect blend of heartfelt moments and an epic scope and feel, along with small, humorous character moments that add some fun that makes it just as entertaining on multiple viewings. Black Panther is a character that I've always loved, but I didn't have tons of his comics. He's mostly someone who I saw when he appeared in guest appearances or when he was a member of the Avengers. But seeing him in live action is even more fantastic to me than most other comic characters, and the world of Wakanda was done so well, and I was very impressed with how they portrayed it. I still remember back in 2015, when Wakanda was mentioned in Age of Ultron, and all of us freaked out. Or even in Iron Man 2, when there was a tiny little blip on the map in Africa, and we thought how cool it would be to see Black Panther in a movie someday, even though our dreams would probably never come to fruition. Until now. Now we have a whole movie about it. There are several characters here that I think will become beloved to fans pretty quickly, especially if we see them pop up in more Marvel films. There's T'Challa's sister Shuri, there's M'Baku, the Man-Ape, and the awesome head of the Dora Milaje, Okoye. I definitely want to see more of them in the future, more than any other Marvel supporting cast actually. And the villains! The main antagonists were Killmonger, a great new addition to the MCU, may he rest in peace, and Claw, who I was really sad to see die as well. Marvel sometimes gets a lot of flack for not fully utilizing villains to their full potential, but worry not, because Black Panther, despite having maybe the least known villain since Ant-Man, I mean seriously, they literally have to use an Iron Man villain for Ant-Man's sequel because his rogues gallery already ran dry from the first one. Anyway, they went all out and included many of T'Challa's supporting cast from the comics, and they absolutely did them justice. What I loved about Killmonger the most is that despite him being a villain in T'Challa's story, he's the hero of his own. He wanted to take control of Wakanda, yes, but he did so because he intended to use her technology and weapons to go out into the world and show who they really are and what they can do. He wasn't just a villain trying to take over the world, he was trying to change it for the better. It was merely the way he did it that made him the antagonist. And I do wish they hadn't killed Claw, even though it was an important plot point. It made complete sense to kill Killmonger, because he's what I think of as a one-off villain. He had a motivation, he attempted what he wanted to do, but lost. Whereas I consider Claw a recurring villain. He is driven by a concept as opposed to a cause, like money. And I thought Claw would be a perfect recurring villain for the MCU, so they could have easily made it where they could use him in the future, especially since this was already his second film. But I guess not. People really like killing off Andy Serkis characters, don't they?
Hello darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again. Because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was sleeping. And the vision that was planted in my brain still remains within the sound of silence. In restless dreams I walked alone.
Well, my precious, time for music, isn't it? No, it's not. Shut your face.
Another thing I noticed and really appreciated was that all the jokes were natural. Sometimes humor and jokes in the MCU are told in a way that it makes it seem like they only said that or did that for the audience. But in Black Panther, all of the humor was done in a way that it was the characters telling a joke to someone else or amusing themselves, like M'Baku did when he cracked himself up. But it was never done just for the audience's sake. And I'm glad the trailers didn't really tell me too much about what the plot was actually about, because I went in not knowing really anything. which was refreshing. And I was continuously blown away by the story and writing. And the visuals, amazing. So as you can tell, I don't really have too much to complain about here. It's been a while since I had a movie like this that didn't warrant at least a little nerdy nitpick here or there. But any possible criticisms I've heard from other people, either I totally don't agree with, or it was something that I actually enjoyed about it. So if you haven't seen it yet, well, go see it. And tell me what you thought. Thanks for watching, everyone. I really appreciate it. Nuff said, and Excelsior.